In the summer of 1864, President Lincoln finally finds an officer who can face the bloody numbers of this hellacious war. Ulysses S. Grant, now commanding the largest army in the world, 500,000 strong. When he faces Lee for the first time, he is soundly defeated. But unlike every other Northern general before him, he does not retreat. He forges ahead relentlessly towards Richmond. Lee surmises Grant's intentions and marches quickly to stop him. General Grant concentrates his army next to Cold Harbor, where Lee has already staked his position. General Grant brings to the confrontation 120,000 men and a supply line that extends for miles. The bloody battle begins.
Don't just sit there. I got word we're on the move. We're gonna kill them Yanks near the river ford, then light up their telegraph. Just for fun, we'll blow up the bridge. How's that sound? Thank you.
On June 3rd, General Grant hurls three corps of men at Lee's entrenched army. The battle is quick and decisive. In 20 minutes, 7,000 men are killed. Despite the terrible loss of life, it's a standoff. The South stops the North temporarily, but cannot halt their relentless march on Richmond. Despite its heroism and willingness to sacrifice all for the Confederacy, the South cannot match the superior numbers and resources of the Union. The end is in sight for the brave soldiers in blue. A city on the south side of the Appomattox River, Petersburg is the South's last stronghold between Grant's army and Richmond, the capital of the Confederacy. In June of 1864, the Federals attack. Lee knows he cannot ultimately win, but has no choice but to defend the city. A long siege begins. Union forces lay siege for 9 long months. The Confederates build massive entrenchments to beat off the superior northern forces. On April 2nd, 1865, Federals make a breakthrough into the city. In Petersburg, everything burns, and every street captured must be paid for in blood. Finally, the Union makes its way towards the last point of Confederate resistance.
take cover now!
I don't know about you, but I want to be the one to tear down that rebel flag. Just so you get the joy of putting up the Stars and Stripes today. You with me?
Broken, Lee's army is finally forced to retreat. President Davis is in church when he receives a message from Lee that he can no longer hold Petersburg. Richmond must be evacuated. This terrible war that divided neighbor from neighbor and tore families apart is close to its bloody end. After losing well over 100,000 men in this battle alone, Grant has done what no other Northern general has achieved. From now on, the country is finally able to look towards the future and begin the great healing process that will unite the nation once again.